Remember to follow all posted safety instructions. This video demonstrates how to square the stationary and carriage end lumber conveyors and hold downs. Stationary end squaring. Step 1. Measure the distance between these two points at the infeed side on the stationary end lumber conveyor. Repeat this at the outfeed side of the stationary end lumber conveyor and remember this measurement. Step 2. Remove one of these bolts at the infeed side of the stationary end lumber conveyor and loosen the other one. Make a mark on the infeed side frame to show the distance the stationary end lumber conveyor needs to move. Manually move the infeed side of the stationary end lumber conveyor in or out until it is at the mark, which means the measurement matches the measurement at the outfeed side. Accuracy should be within 1/16 of an inch. Step 3. Double check that the stationary end lumber conveyor is now square with the saw frame. Reinstall the bolt removed in step 2 and tighten the other one. Step 4. Squaring the stationary end hold downs. Measure the distance between these two points at the infeed side of the stationary end hold down. Repeat this at the outfeed end of the stationary end hold down and remember this measurement. Step 5. Remove the shoulder bolt at the infeed side of the stationary end hold down. After removing the bolt and before moving the hold down, make a mark showing where it needs to be moved. Then, lifting it slightly, move the infeed side of the stationary end hold down in or out to match the measurement at the outfeed side. Step 6. Double check that the stationary end hold down is now square with the saw frame. Reinstall the bolt removed in step 5. The stationary end lumber conveyor and hold down should now be square, but double check between these points on the stationary end lumber conveyor and hold down. Comparing the infeed and outfeed side measurements, ensure they are within 1/16 of an inch. The stationary end of the saw can now be used as a reference for the carriage end of the saw. Carriage end squaring. Step 1. On the carriage end, measure between the hold-down anchors on the infeed side of the lumber conveyors. Compare this with the measurement taken between the hold-down anchors on the outfeed side. No hold-down adjustment is needed if the measurements are within 1/16 of an inch. Step 2. If any adjustment is needed, remove the shoulder bolt like the one shown at the stationary end hold-down. Then, lifting it slightly, move the infeed side of the carriage end hold down in or out to match the measurement at the outfeed side. Step 3. To make sure the lumber conveyors are square, measure between these plates by pushing the tape against one side and under the other side at the infeed side of the lumber conveyors. Step 4. Compare with the same measurement at the outfeed side of the lumber conveyors. Step 5. If adjustment is needed, follow these guidelines. If adjustment is required, it is usually a good practice to adjust the side that needs to move away from the saw blade to ensure the lumber conveyors are not too close to the blades. To move the carriage end lumber conveyor away from the saw blades on the carriage end, remove the bolt closest to the blades and loosen the one most distance from the blades. To move the carriage end lumber conveyor towards the saw blades on the carriage end, remove the bolt furthest from the saw blades and loosen the one closest to the saw blades. Step 6. Double check that the carriage end hold down is now square with the saw frame. Then reinstall the shoulder bolt removed in step 2. The carriage end lumber conveyor and hold down should now be square. If you have any further issues or questions, please contact MiTek Automation Support via phone or email.